How you doing, everybody? This is Iceman here, and we're right here at the Galloping Ghost Arcade. I have with me Daniel Pesina, known as Johnny Cage, Dr. Philip, known as Shang Tsung from Kombat 2, and I'm just here to do random questions, at least 4 questions to both people with a random selected character question out of nowhere. So my first question is to Mr. Pesina. Can you tell me a little bit about the story behind the Johnny Cage character?
Well, behind the character of Johnny Cage, it fluctuated. Originally, I was going to do a different character, Striker. And only that changed to Johnny Cage after Van Damme wanted more money to shoot in the video game. And at the time, we were shooting, it was low budget. They thought that the amount of money he was going to be asking for was too much. So it was a parody, the Jean-Claude Van Damme parody. Yeah, I actually got the costume. The costume was actually stuff I have laying around the house. So it was very, yeah, it's so 80s.
Yeah, that's great.
So, Dr.
Philip,
what is the character or the story behind Shang Tsung
part 2 that you remember? Ask John Tobias. I was studying medicine when I filmed this, so I just filmed it.
So you just filmed it out of nowhere?
Yeah. They asked me. I'm thankful to Daniel for connecting me with John Tobias. They like me, and I guess I like Greg Brady and the Brady Bunch. I fit the suit.
You fit the suit right at the perfect
time. Initially, John, when he made the character development, left it a little loose, and as we filmed, the kind of stories behind them developed further. So it wasn't like everything was completely planned.
Right.
Kind of, by the senior fan.
So my second question is, when it came to digitizing and doing the moves for the specific character, was there any type of uncomfortableness or something that spurred out of the moment that happened on a specific day or
something? Every time he hit a groin punch, it hurt us.
Not so close. The first days of filming were pretty brutal. I remember showing up with John and Ed met me at the door. We walked into a supposedly empty storage room, and it was full of like desks, lamps, chairs, anything that people didn't want in their office, they put in the storage room. So then John and I took about an hour and a half to clear it out before we could actually start filming anything. We cleared out a little area. In about the first 2 or 3 days of filming, we were very experimental, and we actually erased that. We had footage because, again, we were just learning as we
That's something. How about yourself, Dr. Mack? Had any uncomfortableness of a specific movie?
No, I mean, by the time we filmed Mortal Kombat 1, I was only in 2, so by that time, I took half a day and that was it. I mean, if I remember right, 3 or 4 hours, something like that, and I was done. It was easy for me.
Yeah, I think it's a lot easier when you have most of the people shooting with martial art experience and the people who are actually helping create that martial art experience. I know that now, things have changed, but, if you have a martial artist, you ask for something, it's easy to shoot. And if you want any, hey, you want to change this up to this, you can kind of have, therefore, both have the same artistic qualities. So we'll grow from there. It's not very difficult.
All right, so now it comes down to the random selected question. Well, we're going to begin with you. If there was one thing that you could change about the Johnny Cage character from when you began all the way throughout, what would it be?
Nothing.
Nothing at all?
No. Because if you change anything, it won't be the same game. It's like if Van Damme would have stepped in, we wouldn't have been be able to put our own input into our characters. So the game would have changed. It would have probably made no money.
Yeah.
You put any other group in and it would have, at dynamic would have been different. You know, so you change one person out of that group and it would have not been the same right now.
How about yourself, Sasha? Have you changed anything about Shang Tsung for part two?
Well, even though Shang Tsung is not a taekwondo artist, I am, so maybe a couple of taekwondo kicks. But we're not into like an axe kick or tornado round kick. I don't know if that would tornado round kick. I don't know if that would have been able to be digitized, you know, but I know the axe kick. I've seen it done in like Tekken and so forth, so something like that. But otherwise not much.
Now finally, in your opinion, for Johnny Cage, or what would your definition be? The legacy of Mortal Kombat, Johnny Cage. In your opinion, what is the what is your opinion about the legacy of Mortal Kombat, based on your experience?
I really don't play the game.
Right.
Yeah. So as far as the characters I helped develop, Johnny Cage, Scorpion, Reptile, Sub-Zero, Smoke. I never looked at them as a persona outside of myself. So it's hard to, I know the stories have unfolded different ways, but that's not how we did it during filming. So the storyline is very unfamiliar. And when I look at it, I was like, I associate everything to the actual filming of the game, you know, and having fun with my friends. So when I see the storyline, I'm kind of like, I can't really follow it. I'm like, who thought of that?
Yeah.
they apparently this person wasn't in the room filming.
Right.
You know?
Most definitely.
Yes.
And how about yourself, Dr.
What was the question?
What is, in your opinion, what do you think is the legacy of Mortal Kombat based on your experience with the character Shang Tsung?
I mean, Shang Tsung is with what I've been told.
The most popular
of the Shang Tsung, I hope. So that's the only legacy I carry with me. And then
his friendship should have been selfish.
No. I don't know.
I wouldn't change it, man. To be honest, Shang Tsung is one of my all-time favorites. I played Johnny Cage 2. I got familiarized with all of the characters throughout the 20 years that I've played Mortal Kombat. And I mean, I can go on and on. The bottom line is, you know, my respect is for you guys, because out of all of the video games that I've played, Mortal Kombat really rises to the top. And already after 20 years, people still talk about it.
I recently visited fans in Chile. There was close to the Mortal Kombat first, probably like 6,000-7,000.
In
one day.
Yeah.
I was there 3 days, so each time there was different people. It was like very generation. I was introduced to people, hey, I love Mortal Kombat, this is my son, this is my daughter, we play Mortal Kombat together.
And I've seen the footage from Taylor. Gracious skill is the way they play the characters, they go beyond belief.
Yeah, they dress up in the characters. If they're going to play the game, they all get dressed up.
It is a phenomenon.
The fans in Chile are awesome.
Big phenomenon. Well, gentlemen, thank you very much for your time. You have a good day. And let us continue with Mortal Kombat for more years to come. Good night, America.